This is episode 7. If you are new to the series, you may want to start at the beginning.
Hey Aileen, I'm worried.
About what?
Planet Earth. She hasn't called in 3 weeks.
Huh.
Something is wrong. Where is she?
Well, obviously she's here. We're standing on her as we talk.
You think our stories are too extreme?
No, I think our stories are pretty appropriate. They're always based on positive change, and so I don't think that would be the problem. I'm sure she's fine. She might just be busy watching TED videos.
I should try to call her, just to check in. It's weird.
Yeah, give her a call.
Yeah. Thing is, I don't know how to dial her number. There's no country code.
Well, have you tried?
No. Okay, I'm going to give it a shot. Straight numbers, no country code. Do we have a story to tell her? Or?
Yeah, let me think. You can tell her the story of Nohra Padilla. That's a good one, actually. Here you go.
Thank you. Let's see.
I'm sure she'll love listening to this one. And she'll probably appreciate the gesture, too.
Hey, Aileen. Thanks for being the best. Because I know I'm a little bit, yeah. You always have good advice. You're patient.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay.
You have reached the voicemail box of Planet Earth.
Hey, it's Camille. I'm worried. You haven't called in 3 weeks. I don't know. I thought I would check in. You don't answer my text messages. Is there anything wrong? Actually, I came with a story I want to tell you. It's a bit weird to do this via voicemail, but at least you can listen to it whenever you want. I hope you do, and I hope you like it. So... Well, let me get into the storytelling mood. Now, it's the story of a little girl from Bogota called Nohra. She's 7 years old. Her family came to the capital after fleeing violence in the rural areas of the country. Now they spend most of their time picking up garbage at the foot of this huge municipal landfill where tons and tons of waste are dumped every day. That's how they make a living. Actually, they're not picking up garbage. That's not how they see it. They are treasure hunting. They sift through mountains of trash, looking for the most valuable materials they can find, either for themselves or to sell. And they are not the only ones, of course. There are thousands of people in extreme poverty treasure hunting as well. It's a tough job. Physically, mentally, it's dangerous, and it provides very little money at the end of the month. One day, the local government prohibited the access to the landfill. No treasure hunting anymore. So people started taking waste picking to the streets. And that brought other kinds of problems. Daily discrimination was one of them. The community of waste pickers was marginalized to the point where it became forbidden to pick up trash, as the government said. We're talking here about the livelihood of tens of thousands of people in the city that was taken away by this new law. At this point, the little Nohra had grown up. We are in 1991. Nohra had now become a well-respected waste picker. She had developed an extensive knowledge of material identification. She was able to organize and optimize operations, and she had a solid, hard-working reputation. Most importantly, she had a dream. In her dream, informal waste pickers became recognized as environmental stewards. They were paid correct wages by the city. They were organized, respected. Social justice. In her dream, waste pickers were a true competitive force against the trash multinationals, who, as you know, promote infrastructure-intensive solutions that are nothing else than expensive and centralized power structures. She had a dream, and she knew that everything is possible. So in 1991, Nohra and her team started organizing the waste pickers in cooperatives. That was a huge piece of work. They started from nothing. They had to get people educated, to get them to recognize their own value. They had to organize processes, teams, secure space, and go through all of the legal matters that would give the cooperatives a legal right to operate. They had to be able to bid for governmental contracts. No one could believe they were taking this on. New faces welcome now at the meeting place. Little by little, they were getting ready. Once they started going after those contracts, they had to face other kinds of problems. They were being robbed, they were being humiliated as well. Nohra was receiving death threats, so she requested state protection, which was denied. All this was a sign that they were starting to drive change. The trash multinationals could see the storm coming. But it was a long, long battle. You know, we sometimes feel good things can happen overnight, but they usually don't. Fast forward, we are now in 2013. 22 years after the first efforts to organize cooperatives. 22 years later. That year, Nohra and the cooperatives won a landmark court battle.
Nuestra fuerza de trabajo. Con todo el aprecio y con todo el respeto, quisiéramos insistir en que haya un papel o que haya una mención del trabajo de las cooperativas y de la economía social y solidaria dentro de la transición del proceso de pasar de la economía informal a la formalidad. Gracias.
As a result of this victory in court, Bogota's mayor, Gustavo Petro, issued a decree mandating recycling throughout the city, stating that recyclers are to be paid for their services, and establishing a system whereby recyclers can sort through material before it goes to a landfill. In other words, the once informal waste pickers became official personnel of sanitation of the city. And as you can imagine, it was a groundbreaking victory.
Yo soy Nohra Padilla, soy recicladora. Mi trabajo principal es motivar a que los recicladores se organicen y defiendan su oficio, que entre todos le aportemos a esta sociedad la protección del medio ambiente, el ahorro de recursos y el respeto por las personas.
They had built a system that can handle, sort and process 1,500 tons of waste per day. Grassroots, baby. Through this work, Nohra created the perfect bridge between social justice and environmental goals. Waste pickers typically lived in extreme poverty with little to no employment rights. But in recent years, many of them have seen their earnings double or triple, and everyone is now aware of the role they're playing for the city. Nohra Padilla created a model. She showed it is possible. And she now represents the country's recycler association. And beyond her dream coming true in her home country, Nora's model is inspiring communities of waste pickers all around the world. Her international union counts more than 1.5 million waste pickers from 5 continents. 1.5 million. So the little 7-year-old girl, learning waste picking at the foot of the Bogota landfill, turned into an international hero. I like this story very much. It's another example showing that everything is possible, as you told me the other day, remember? Okay, well, that's it. I hope everything's okay and that you'll call back soon. We miss talking to you. Take care.
Ah, she's gonna like this.
Yeah, I hope so. You know, I was thinking, maybe we're approaching this all wrong.
How do you mean?
Well, maybe we're not giving her exactly what she needs.
Nah, I wouldn't worry too much about all this. But we're going to be late. We need to get going.
Oh yeah? Where to?
Yeah, we have to kick off the meeting for the new series about oceans.
Oh yeah, that's right. Talking about the blue planet. Okay, I'm coming.